Hi, this is a safety tip brought to you from the Certified Horsemanship Association. My name is Teresa Cacker. This is my assistant, Tara Gamble, helping me hold our beautiful American quarter horse today, Skeeter. I'm going to talk to you today about using some bandages and wraps on your horse. This is traditionally what we're going to use is a standing bandage. Standing bandages are very helpful if your horse tends to have done some hard work, might get a little stocked up, especially in the hind legs, and you need to give them a little extra support. You can also use a standing bandage if your horse is going to be doing something, let's say you're at a horse show and they're going to be a little restless in their stalls and you don't want them to nick their tendons or their cannon bones. Standing bandages can be very helpful for that as well. And sometimes some people will actually use a standing bandage for shipping. So just a few different options. This is going to be our primary padding for our bandage. This is called a no-bow wrap. You always would want to do a standing bandage with padding. You would never use a standing bandage with just a track wrap alone, always with padding. So what you're going to do is you're going to take your padding, whichever you want to use. Some people will use pillow wraps, and you can use the no-bows, which are really helpful. And I'm going to take my track wrap, put it inside my standing bandage, and I'm just going to wrap it snugly, or inside my no-bow, and just wrap it snugly and evenly. Make sure your tops are even here, otherwise you'll have problems when you do begin wrapping your horse. As your bandage starts to uncurl, it'll be uneven on your horse's leg. Now, our primary area of protection on our horse is going to be the cannon bone, so we do want to make sure that we're wrapping between the knee and the fetlock itself. A few safety issues that you want to take into mind when you do begin wrapping your horse is make sure that your horse is going to be comfortable with the wrap itself, so you won't be startling them or surprising them. And do make sure that your horse is either held by someone or tied securely if they've been wrapped regularly. If it's a new horse, new to bandaging, make sure that you have somebody hold it. You do want to make sure that you're clear of the hind legs, so if your horse did start to cow kick, and you would never actually want to sit down or put your knees all the way on the ground, you would want to be squatting the entire time. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my wrap and I'm going to place it so the loose or the starting portion of my wrap lays inside the inner groove of the horse's tendons. So if you look here at his off leg, I'm going to lay my wrap right through here so that this area is covered by the wrap primarily when I start. So I'm going to lay my wrap in here. I want to make sure my wrap is always smooth and straight underneath, and I'm going to put a mild amount of pressure as I wrap around. You don't want to pull because you want your padding or your bandaging to support but not be constrictive. So as I've wrapped my no bow around, now I can take my track wrap. I'm going to go down first. This is the front of your horse's cannon bone, and this is where you want to put the pressure that you'll top pull or tighten your wrap with. So you're going to pull against the cannon bone, wrapping firmly around. I'm on the cannon bone. I'm going to add a soft pressure, a little tug. And as I go down, you always want to make sure you leave a margin on the bottom and on the top of your wrap so that your wrap doesn't come off of your pillow or your no-bow and cause a pressure point. Very important while you're wrapping your bandage to make sure it's smooth with no wrinkles or inconsistencies throughout. As I work my way up to the top, you do want to make sure that you have that margin at the top. And they do sell different length track wraps as well as different length pillow or no-bow bandages, so you can get the appropriate length for your horse's front and back legs. I'm going to finish with a nice front here with my bandage velcroed on. If your horse might be extra restless, you might want to also tape with masking tape around the bandage fastener also. All right, the other wrap we're going to talk about today is a polo wrap. So a polo wrap is primarily used while the horse is actually being ridden. You would never want to use a polo wrap, put your horse in the stall and leave them unattended because they can come unraveled or loosen quite easily. So a polo wrap would only be used while your horse is being ridden. So when we do our polo wrap, we're also going to keep in mind our safety considerations. We're going to make sure we're clear of the back end of the horse and comfortable. And we're not going to put our knees on the ground or get too low. So again, just like we did with our standing bandage, I'm going to take and put the end of my polo wrap on the inside portion of the horse's cannon. I'm going to start about mid-cannon. This is your horse's cannon bone. I'm going to start about mid-cannon. I'm going to begin wrapping. As I do so, I'm gonna make sure I overlap each one just a little bit. And if I, with these polos, you don't really pull so much tight, but you do wanna have constant steady pressure. Now, as I come down to the horse's fetlock joint, you'll notice I'm angling my polo wrap back towards the ground. So as I do that, I'm gonna come under the fetlock joint to help support the joint. I'm gonna come back up around, and you'll see I do have a little bit of a gap here. That gap is perfectly acceptable. What you'll do with your next wrap is then come straight across and cover that little gap up. So no debris or dirt or shavings or anything else could get stuck in that while you're actually riding your horse. As I work my way back up the horse's cannon bone, I'm just going to take little small even wraps with consistent pressure as I go up to the base of the horse's knee joint. They do sell polo wraps in a variety of sizes, so you can get the appropriate length for each horse's leg and cannon size. As I finish, I'm just gonna attach my polo wrap here. If you're using your horse in a situation where they might actually catch this tape on a brushing boot or on the other leg, you can also use a little bit of masking tape to seal this down, or some vinyl tape as well. And that will keep it safe. Be careful when you do use your polo wraps that you're not riding in a heavy, brushy area, a place where you might pick up burrs or foxtails, because those could actually work their way into the polo fabric themselves and cause the horse some irritation. So that's our polo wrap and our standing bandage. Thank you so much. Alrighty, when you're all done riding and you're ready to wrap your polos back up after, of course, they've been laundered, the easiest thing to do is to lay your polos across a gate or fence, or something where you can keep them smooth and out of the dirt or debris. They do like to pick up all kinds of little sawdust and particles. Then you're gonna take and you're gonna make sure that when you wrap your wraps, you wrap them Velcro to Velcro. So you'll see the little Velcro strip, that needs to be on the inside of your wrap. The tighter you wrap your wraps, the easier it will be to apply them with consistent, even pressure. So it's important when you do wrap your wraps that they're snug and even as you wrap this way too. You wouldn't want them wrapped unevenly anywhere. So I'm just gonna put a little pressure with my left hand as I pull with my right hand against my thigh so that I can roll them evenly and smoothly and still get a nice tight wrap. As we continue to wrap, you can also move in a little bit, making sure you keep it as even as possible with steady, consistent pressure. And I'll show you a handy little way to store your polo wraps after you take all the time to put them in there that they don't come undone. You can take the tail end of your wrap, tuck it into the next layer, and just tuck it through like this, and your wrap will stay wrapped until you're ready to use it again.